One out of every two men and one out of every three women will be diagnosed with an invasive cancer in their lifetime. For this reason, it's really important to know more about what cancer is, what makes it up, and how it's treated.
At the simplest level, cancer or cancer cells are cells that have lost the ability to follow the normal control that the body exerts on all cells. In our body, we have billions and billions of cells, and they have different functions. It's a very complicated process under incredibly phenomenal control. And if something goes wrong and that control is lost, and particular cells escape the normal control mechanisms, and they continue to grow, and they may spread, that's what we call cancer.
As those cells grow and divide, they turn into a mass, or they clump together, and that's what we would call a tumor. And then they can get smart and then spread other places, and that's what we call metastasis.
Cancer can actually occur anywhere in the body because there are cells everywhere in the body. In women, one of the most common cancers, of course, is breast cancer, and in men, prostate cancer. And in both men and women, lung cancer and colon cancer are common cancers.
One of the things we're now learning is that just because you have breast cancer, doesn't mean that your breast cancer is the same as the person that's sitting next to you that may have breast cancer. And therefore, you can get an individual treatment plan that's based on you as an individual and your particular cancer type.
Once the diagnosis of cancer is made, of course, the next obvious question is, what do you do? There are several things that are really relevant. The stage of the cancer, which is information about where is the cancer. You say it's a particular kind of cancer, how much cancer is present? Has it spread? Is it in lymph nodes? Has it spread to other organs of the body? Cancer treatment actually is very complex. And part of the reason is because cancer is this constellation of over 200 different diseases. They have common characteristics, but they're all very different from each other. In addition to that, the cancer itself is not homogeneous. There may be 3 or 4 or 5 or 6 different slight variations in the cancer cells that are there. People ask, why? Why does my cancer not go away? It shrunk by 70%. What's wrong with the other 30%? Well, it's probably a different subtype of that cancer, which is going to require a different kind of treatment.
The primary methods for treatment of cancer are surgery, radiation, and chemotherapy. Surgery is when you literally remove the cancer. You make an incision, you find the cancer, and you cut it out. Radiation is actually taking what we call photons, same thing that you use to take an X-ray picture in order to treat a focal area of cancer. Chemotherapy is using a drug or chemical that's either taken by mouth as a pill or given through an IV into the vein, targeting those cells that are dividing more quickly.
Receiving a diagnosis of cancer can be a frightening thing. The good news is that today is probably the most exciting time in history in terms of the treatment of cancer. Options that didn't exist a few months ago certainly didn't exist a few years ago, like the ability to genomically profile a tumor and to take that individualized fingerprint of that cancer may direct us to tailor treatment in very specific ways.
As we learn genetic abnormalities in individual cancers, we're able to more effectively target those abnormalities for the individual cancer, not only to improve the outcome for the patients relative to the cancer, but also hopefully result in less side effects because the targets will hopefully be less in the normal tissue and more in the cancer itself.
New drugs have now been designed to teach the immune system how to see the cancer cells for what they are, so the immune system can actually do the job at killing off those cells. We've unlocked a key interaction in how cancer cells and immune cells interact, and by affecting that interaction, teaches the immune cell to be smarter and see the cancer cell for what it is and get rid of them.
At Cancer Treatment Centers of America, we have a very robust integrative oncology program. Integrative oncology is taking those conventional oncology treatments and integrating those with therapies like acupuncture, naturopathic medicine, chiropractic, nutrition, to blend those together and to create the most appropriate treatment plan for that individual patient at that moment in time.
So having your symptoms and side effects under control, having your nutritional status and your immune system, as well as your energy supported during treatment, better positions you to fight the cancer and tolerate the treatment course. Cancer Treatment Centers of America has all of the resources under one roof. All of these team members really try to address any sort of side effects or symptoms that you may be having before they occur. If we can keep your body strong, if we can keep your hope up and you feeling strong emotionally, and if we can keep your immune system in a good place, you're going to tolerate the treatment much better.
No matter what cancer you have, this is a person who has a life and family and friends and so forth. And so my goal as an oncologist is to not only get rid of the cancer, but for you to then live a normal life again.
I've been an oncologist now for over 30 years, and the options for treatment are the best that I've ever seen them. They're more effective with fewer side effects and faster recovery, so that you can live as normal life as long as you can. You've never had better opportunities than we do today.